You guys are all investors. Every time you spend money, you are basically investing in something. And today, I'm hoping to get you to think about what you're actually investing in. Kalamazoo is home to many of you, and it's a home away from home to the rest. Whichever one that is, Kalamazoo's economy affects you in numerous ways. It can affect your cost of living, it can affect how much your education costs, and it's gonna affect you when you graduate from here and are looking for a job. So today, I'm hoping to talk to you about why I think you should buy local, some ideas of what the term local actually means and defines, and what you can actually do to buy local. Local First, an IBA out of Grand Rapids, which is an independent business alliance, hired Civic Economics Group back in 2008 to do a study. And they basically wanted to find out how much money remained in the community when spent locally compared to when spent not locally. And what they found was very significant. Out of $100, $73 remains in the community when spent at a local independent business. Now, only $43 remains in the community when spent elsewhere at a non-local or non-independent business. It's a huge difference. Buying local also has huge economic benefits to our community outside of that. One of them is it supports local job creation. Not only do new local businesses bring in jobs, they hire locally, which means from the very top, from the CEO all the way to the bottom, those are all members of your community. Those are your neighbors. I recently interviewed Gloria Tiller, and she's the volunteer of Buy Local Kalamazoo, which is our local IBA, our local independent business alliance. And it's a completely volunteer-ran organization of small business owners in our community. And she told me a lot of things. And one of the things she told me was actually that they practice this concept of local supporting local, which basically means that if an independent business in the organization needs something, before going outside the organization or outside of Buy Local, they go to other independent local businesses for those goods and services, and so on and so forth. So it's like a chain effect, and they all practice that. Also, you get personal knowledgeable service. And a main reason for that is this is their way of living. This is how they support their family. This is how they basically live their life the way they do. And because of that, they're invested in you as a consumer. Because without you, they wouldn't be able to live their lives the way they do. And because of that, they stay educated as much as possible. And when you do come and see them, you get a very personable approach. And Kurt and Sinclair did a study for the Journal of Agriculture and Human Values in 2009. And what they found was that by bringing the producer of goods and the seller of goods closer to the consumer gains intelligence. So yes, you actually become smarter when you do buy local. And this is like social networking. There's no difference. The only thing is you're not on your computer. When you go to that business or that local business, or go to that local restaurant and talk to that waitress or talk to the owner, that person lives in your community. They know people in your community. They might have kids that go to school to your kids or brothers that go to school to your brothers. I mean, you're basically expanding your horizons. Now, the term local actually doesn't have a definite definition. There is not one that exists. But there's a few different guidelines. It's basically locally owned and operated. We all understand that. The American Independent Business Alliance has a few other guidelines. One of them is that it at least has to be 50% owned by a local area resident, and that resident must maintain full authority on all decisions regarding that company or small business. And it has to be maintained in a certain region or in a certain state. So it basically, in either a corner of a state or a state as a whole, it cannot go outside of the boundaries. And as consumers, your guys' opinion actually matters more than most people realize. A study done for the University of Illinois found that 70% of people, usually the people they polled, 70% of them decided 50 miles was the radius. That's the radius of what they considered local. And if all else fails, you can ask to talk to the owner. If they laugh at you or get you a middle manager, it's probably not a local business. And what can you do? It's honestly that simple. You can buy local. It doesn't get easier than that. It's basically changing your spending habits. When we all want groceries, goods, stuff like that, we go to larger department stores. We go to the Myers and the Walmarts because it's easier. It is. I agree. Sometimes it is. Now switch that concept around, because when we go to Myers and we don't find what we want, we take a step back. We go to the local stores and find it. And sometimes we find it, sometimes we don't. But switch that around. Go to the local stores first. A good example of that would be if you're in the market for running shoes, and instead of going to the mall or the department store to get a new pair of running shoes, right downtown, for example, is Gazelle Sports. Anybody who's ever been to Gazelle Sports will tell you they have some of the best customer service employees in Kalamazoo, and they sell the same shoes the mall do. And educate yourself. Find out who and where these places are. In a moment, I'll give you some websites that'll help you do that. And once you educate yourself, educate your friends, your peers, your coworkers, lead by example. Because when people come to Kalamazoo from out of the town, you don't want to take them to Applebee's. They have an Applebee's. They know what it tastes like. It tastes the same. Take them someplace around the area. Take them to Food Dance. The food co-op downtown, there's all types of places. Now, that's a little bit about buying local. And I hope after talking about it, you guys found out that it's an extremely important concept to practice. I told you why you should buy local, what the term local actually means, and how you can participate in the concept of buying local. It's probably one of the easiest and most convenient ways you contribute to your community. It's really not about how much or how little you buy, it's about where you buy it. And some of these websites I was mentioning earlier, Buy Local Kalamazoo, that's our local IBA that represents the businesses in Kalamazoo. Fair Food Matters and People's Food Co-op actually are located downtown. And we are very lucky to have two local food vendors and sellers located right downtown in our own area. And the American Independent Business Alliance, that's their website. And that's just a good reference if you're kind of either wanting to start up an independent business or want to know more about them. So thank you, Buy Local and Invest in Kalamazoo.